Yesterday in our discussions, we have come across finding degree of freedom for planar mechanisms using Gruber's criterion. Here we can see degree of freedom for a given mechanism will be is given by this formula, where this is 3 into n minus 1 is number of movable links, and r is the degree of constraints or number of constraints for the total mechanism. And this restraint or number of constraints is found from now total number of higher pairs and total number of lower pairs. For lower pairs, for one lower pair, say revolute joints. Why I am calling revolute joints as a lower pair is, in this pair, about this joint, only rotation can happen. Translations are abolished or eliminated. So two constraints are there for one lower pair. So when j lower pairs are there, 2j constraints or 2j restraints. And when we come to higher pair, say a cam pair or rolling with sliding. In this, as sliding is there at the point of contact, certain velocity will be there, that is translational velocity, and another due to rolling also it will proceed, that one more motion is there. So if we give omega or angular velocity, we will find with what speed it is rolling, and along with that the sliding adds further to its total velocity. So there are two components that are independent of each other. So only one constraint is there. Because in a planar mechanism, total maximum possible is 3. When there are two independent parameters, only one is the constraint. So for each higher pair, only one constraint. So 1h, 1 into h number of restraints for h number of higher pairs. So substituting these two in this final formula for degrees of freedom for a given planar mechanism will be 3 of n minus 1 minus 2 into j minus h. This will be the formula of degree of freedom for planar mechanisms, where j is number of lower pairs, where h is number of higher pairs. Hope this is clear. From this now let us do some examples. When coming to examples, one, first of all we will count number of links in this example. Fixed link, first of all, before going to that, you have to understand I have specified some brackets for these two links, one bracket, for these two, this line, one bracket. This bracket specifies this, that this whole link is a single, this total entity is a single link combined by this bracket. Similarly, this whole thing is a single unit combined by this bracket. So this total thing we will count as one link, not as two links joined at here. So this one is one link and this is one link. Similarly, this is one link and this is another link. So this is not a, this is just a binary joint. We will not count it as a quaternary. Okay. So we will proceed like that. Here we have a slider. So fixed link will be link 1. This total thing will be link 2, this total thing will be link 3, this total thing will be link 4, this total thing will be link 5, this will be link 6, this will be link 7, and this slider is link 8, and again this is a fixed link. So total 8 number of links. Now let us count number of lower pairs. Lower pairs generally are revolute joints and sliding pairs. Here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I will count it, then I will mark it better. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Here this one 9. and here sliding is there, so this one 10. So total 10 number of lower pairs, area type of contacts, which is having 1 degree of freedom or 2 restraints. So and higher, there are no higher pairs. So from that degree of freedom, we find that 3 into n minus 1, n is number of links, which is 8, minus 1, minus 2 into j. J is nothing but number of lower pairs, which is 10. Minus number of 1 into number of higher pairs, which is 0. So total it is 21 minus 20, which is 1. Degree of freedom of this particular thing is 1. Now coming to the second example, there we find a spring. Earlier we have discussed that spring is equivalent to two links joined by a binary joint. So we have to first of all make it into an equivalent mechanism. This is a fixed link, and here instead of spring, two links joined by as a binary pair, you can say two links joined by a revolute joint, turning pair. Okay, now naming the links. This is a fixed link, first one. This is second one, internal third. This is 4, this is 5, this is 6. So total number of links 6. Now number of lower pairs, first revolute joint, second, third, here 4, here 5, here 6. So j equals to 6. Number of links, n equals to 6. Number of higher pairs, h equals to 1 cam pair, so 1. Therefore degree of freedom will be equal to 3 into n minus 1, which is 5, minus 2 into 6, minus 1, which is equals to 2, 15 minus 13. Hope this sum is clear. Okay, now we will go to next problem. When we are looking at this one, here again I have specified a bracket. So this whole thing is a single link with a revolute joint here, here and here. These are revolute joints. So here no higher pair, we cannot see any higher pair there, all are revolute joints only. So all are lower pairs. So naming the links first, this is first link, fixed link. This is second link, this is third link, this is fourth link, this is fifth link. Okay, so n equals to 5. Now coming to revolute joints, 1, 2, 3, I will mark it better. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So number of revolute joints or number of lower pairs here are 6. Number of higher pairs is 0, which implies degree of freedom equals to 3 into n minus 1, 4, minus 2 into j is 6, minus 1 into h, 0. 3, 4 is a 12, minus 2, 6 is a 12, which is 0. So degree of freedom for this mechanism is 0, which specifies that this mechanism is a structure, redundant chain. If we free this one, this actually fixed, so if we free this one, this is a redundant chain. As it is fixed, it is a structure. Okay? This, all things we are getting by groupless criterion. But there is one exception for this. For the same sum, these lengths are different. If we take another example where all the lengths are equal, that is an exceptional case of groupless criterion. Actually, due to equality of lengths, when this rotates, by that this everything rotates as all are equal lengths. This whole, if one input is given, this total setup will move proportionally to this one. Equally, not even proportionally, proportionally constant will be 1. Whatever degrees this is moving, the same degrees this will also move. And so, input and output are correlated by a single parameter. What is the kind of, how much is the rotation we are giving? So, there, degrees of freedom is 1. This is an exception. If we apply Grubler's criterion for this, we will get 0. But this is an exceptional case or violation of Grubler's criterion. This is an important one, you have to note it. Okay, so after this one, we will go to the next topic, design and development of kinematic mechanisms. Earlier we have discussed, we will call that chain as a kinematic chain in which if one link is fixed, its degree of freedom is 1. And nothing but when that link is fixed for a kinematic chain, then it is a kinematic mechanism. So what I mean to say is, for a given chain, when a given kinematic chain, when we fix this thing, this is a mechanism. For this particular thing or particular mechanism, if we get degree of freedom as 1, then that is a kinematic mechanism. But from Grubler's point of view, we have a formula. The degree of freedom is 3 into n minus 1 minus 2 into j minus h equals to 1. From this total, from this thing, we will conclude to this one. So assume this is a simple mechanism in which there are no higher pairs. When there is no higher pair, this will become 0. So only this part remains. From that, j equals to, we will find 3 by 2n minus 2. Since joint, it may be a revolute joint or anything, a joint is a natural number, a positive integer. It is not a fraction. So for this not to be a fraction, n must be an even number so that it is divisible by 2 and the finally we will get a positive integer. So, condition for a mechanism to be kinematic. For a simple mechanism, not a complex one, for a simple mechanism, n must be even number. Again, if we want a closed loop, mechanism should be closed one, should not be like this. If it is like this, then it is not a closed, it is an open. We will not call it as even a mechanism, and now we will not call it as a closed mechanism. So, if we want a closed one, we will at least want 4 links. If that if there is fourth one, then only we can close. You may think, even if there are 3, we can close. But when it is 3, we have found that its degree of freedom will be 0, which is a structure. It is not a kinematic mechanism. So, in order to have as a mechanism, we must have minimum now value of n as 4. So, if we want closed loop. We want this kinematic mechanism as a closed loop, then n must be greater than or equals to 4, and also it must be an even number to have j as a positive integer. Okay, so there are two conditions if in case of closed loop. Okay, so I hope this concept is clear by here. So we will I will give you three conclusions from total. From earlier discussions, we can find that the minimum number of links to form a kinematic mechanism with only lower pairs is 4. Minimum number is 4. Equal to. Minimum is 4. It can be more, but n should be even for having a mechanism with only lower pair. If it also includes one higher pair, then it must be odd. That is a different case. Okay. Now, when it is only 4, then that is a basic mechanism. And whatever are the complex mechanisms we find, that is made up of this basic mechanism. That's why this is a building block for complex mechanisms. This basic mechanism with 4 links is nothing but a 4 bar mechanism, which we will discuss further. Okay, I hope this concept is clear till now. Coming to 4 bar chain, or 4 bar mechanism, let us say this is a shortest link S and this is the longest link L. Remaining is P and Q. Okay. Depending on what link we are fixing, there can be three possibilities of mechanisms we get. One possibility is crank. Another possibility is crank and rocker. Another possibility is rocker. Crank or double crank. Rocker or double rocker. What is this? We will study now. What is crank? What is rocker? Everything we will study now. When a certain link adjacent to this fixed link, when a certain link, this input link or output link, when it is making a complete revolution, link making complete revolution is crank, which can make complete revolutions. Link that can't make complete revolutions . It only oscillates, then that is rocker or oscillator. Okay. Now there is a criterion based on which what type of mechanism we will get. Okay. When one point always to note is the mechanism at any cost is possible only and only if largest link is always less than sum of lengths of other links. That is, L is less than P plus Q plus S. This is anyway an important or necessary condition for mechanism to happen. Now, there is one more criterion. Largest plus smallest link lengths is always, this is compared with sum of link lengths of other two. If largest, here I have just specified this is L, but sometimes it may be L, it may be largest. So if this is just an example I have given. If largest plus smallest is less than P plus Q, then this is a Grashof linkage or mechanism. Okay, and L plus S greater than P plus Q, then it is non-Grashof linkage. Now one more is there, L plus S equal to P plus Q. This is special case of Grashof. Okay, so this first which Grashof linkage is class 1 linkage. It is called as class 1 linkage. Then this non-Grashof linkages are called as class 2 linkages. This is a special case of linkage which we can make it as a class 3, generally not classified like class 3, but we classify this both as a class 1 and 2, remaining is it is their special case, it is class 3. Okay, so up to here you are. One more thing I forgot to mention is this crank or rocker, whichever it is, it is always adjacent to the fixed link. It may be input or output. If it fully rotates, then it is crank. If it also fully rotates, it is also a crank. If it oscillates, then it is a rocker. If it also oscillates, it is also a rocker. And the link opposite to the fixed link is coupler. Why we call it coupler is it is linking or coupling the input link and output link. Okay. Now we go to the next concept. From our earlier discussions, we can conclude to this table where you are able to see that from class 1 type of linkages, there are 3 kinds of mechanisms possible, 3 inversions. Okay? 3, or you can say 2 and 3 are included in 1 only, same type of inversion. This depends on which link you are fixing of that mechanism. If you are fixing shortest link, then this both, if it is input, this input as well as this output both rotates completely, hence it is a double crank mechanism, 2 cranks. Now, if adjacent to shortest, this is shortest, if this one or this one is fixed or this one, then it will lead to crank rocker. Means if Q is fixed, S is shortest but Q is fixed, say, then S will be rotating completely where L will be only oscillating. So one crank and one rocker. If you may fix Q or you may fix P, adjacent to shortest link, if you fix, you will get this one. Similarly, opposite to shortest link, if you fix, you will get both of these links will only oscillate, they will not make complete revolution. So you will get double rocker mechanism. Now this is for Grashof's mechanism linkage, where longest plus shortest is always less than sum of other two link lengths. But if this is violated, that is non-crush of linkage, in that case any link, you will get only one type of inversion, which is double rocker. There will not be any crank at all. And the third and last one is a special case, as we addressed earlier. Class 3 is also same as the class 1, but the only difference is here we have to understand that dead centers do exist. Okay. Dead centers, by dead centers I mean that either the input, when we are giving input continuously, the output reaches its extreme positions either to that side or this side, which we call as a top dead or bottom dead centers or extreme dead centers, extreme positions of the output link, at which it will align itself with the fixed link. Example of one dead center I will say is, if this is a fixed link for the former mechanism, then one possibility is like this. This is one extreme. This is input link, this is output link, which for this mechanism we will attach some slider or something, or it itself may be a slider. It is a maximum position. When it turns this side or that side, this will again draw inside, it will not go any further. Similarly, there will be a certain position where it will come like this or like this, where the slider will be at the innermost part. So that extremes are there. So we will call it as a dead center. And that positions will be aligning or off parallel, either aligned or parallel, depending on the type of linkage we are making. Hope this everything is clear. In special Grashof, I would like to discuss two possible mechanisms. One mechanism is parallelogram. Another is deltoid. These are two special cases. This one already I have discussed earlier, similar kind. So these two are shortest links, these two are longest links. Okay. Whichever link you fix, you will get double crank mechanism. And this, you may get a doubt why it is happening like this. Because earlier we have discussed that if we fix a shortest link, then only it should give double crank. But when we fix longest link, it should be, or it is adjacent. Any link adjacent to shortest link, then it should give a crank and rocker actually. But what is happening here is, when this reaches its extreme position, this is link 1, link 2, link 3, link 4. Actually, we have fixed this big one, fourth one. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, when it is moving extreme, due to moment of inertia at this we will call it a toggle point, you will learn it later. Extreme position, due to moment of inertia, it will need infinitesimally small amount of force. And that inertia force itself is sufficient to move it further down. Due to that, it will start rotating completely instead of coming back. So, what is happening here is, again it is also becoming a crank. This, okay, that is the reason why we are calling it as a double crank mechanism. And in deltoid, instead of same size links opposite, we will fix one small and small adjacent, large and large adjacent. Both the small links joined adjacently, both the large veins joined adjacently. In parallelogram kind of mechanisms, shortest links are oppositely attached and longest links are appositely, I mean they are parallel. But in deltoid, both the shortest links are joined together adjacently and both longest links adjacently. In this case, what happens is shortest link, we already know that when we fix the shortest, we will get double crank. So either you fix this one or you fix this one. Whichever one you fix, any shortest link fixed. This say one inversion we get is double crank. And in case of this shortest, if you fix adjacent to this longest link, this is adjacent to, you may think that this is opposite one, so we should get opposite to shortest, so we should get double rocker mechanism. But this is, though it is opposite to smallest, it is also adjacent to smallest. Due to this adjacent nature, we will get, instead of double rocker, we will get crank and rocker. This will make complete revolutions, this will make rotary or rocker or oscillatory motion. So any longest link, and again this one also, it may be this long length link will be maybe opposite to shortest one, but this at the same time this is adjacent to smallest. Then we are fixing a link which is adjacent to shortest link, we will get a crank and rocker. We will get crank rocker mechanism. So there is no double crank mechanism in this case. Sorry, no double rocker mechanism. Possible in this case. No double rocker possible in this case. Hope the concept is clear up to. Now we will discuss one concept of mechanical advantage. In our elementary classes, we used to study that mechanical advantage is ratio of output to input force or torque. I mean, by how much amount of time, how many times we could able to, we are able to magnify the input torque or force, that we will be calling as mechanical advantage. If we neglect the frictional losses and other losses, then input power equal to output power. If such is the case, in case of a four bar mechanism, say this is input, this is output, then power is given by, if it is link 1, link 2, link 3, link 4, here torque T2 is given and it is rotating with angular velocity omega 2. At the same time, output link is getting a torque of T4 with an angular velocity and turning with angular velocity omega 4. If input power and output power are same, then T2 omega 2 equals to T4 omega 4. From this formula we get that mechanical advantage MA equal to T4 by T2 equal to omega 2 by omega 4. Okay, one thing what we need to consider is, when we get in a double crank mechanism or in a crank rocker mechanism, if this input is a crank, output is rocker, this rocker will go to extreme position and come back. At that maximum point or maximum extreme, this side or that side, its velocity, angular velocity will be zero at that particular instant. So at that particular instant, omega 4 is 0, or I will write it clearly, at extreme position of output link. And for that particular instant, omega 4 will be 0. So for that particular instant, mechanical advantage is infinity. This is what this means is, when it is reaching extreme position, infinitesimally small amount of force is sufficient. We need not pull with a high amount of force. Then a slight moment of inertia itself is sufficient to continue the motion of this rocker. It will get back. Because mechanical advantage, with a small input given, we will get a large amount of output, infinite amount of output. Okay? And the next topic. It is transmission angle. So purpose of these mechanisms and all is to install in machines and get one type of mechanical input into another type of or same type of energy, the output. So when, as we are discussing regarding four bar mechanism only, if this is input, this is output, this is coupler. Coupler is that link which is opposite to the fixed link. So angle between the coupler and the output, this mu, is nothing but the transmission angle. Okay? This transmission angle decides how much amount of force applied by input link is transferred by this coupler to the output. If this mu is 90 degrees, this input link will transmit certain torque, force like this. So this is a coupler force in the coupler due to input link motion. That is 90 degree, this torque applied here will be this force into the complete link length. So total force is effectively transferred to output. So when mu is 90 degree, so the torque is P equals to F into this link length. Say it is P, then F into P. But if mu is other than 90, say it is less than 90 or greater than 90, so the orientation will change. Say it is not 90, for example say not 90. Then the configuration will be something like this. So what happens to this link? This is trying to pull like that. Effective force that is trying to rotate or give output is perpendicular to this. So for this actual force, we have to find the component, so which will automatically reducing. That reduced component only will be taking part in rotating this output link. So whenever mu is other than 90 degree, the coupler, the amount of torque being transmitted reduces. And the transmitted torque is maximum at the instant when mu is 90 degrees. Hope this concept is clear. A chain which will be like this. Now, when we replace this link with a slider, then we will get a slider crank chain or single slider chain. It is better to call it a single slider chain. Then slider crank chain. when we convert, we will get this is 1, 2, 3, 4 links. 1, 2, 3, this slider is 4th link. Okay, this is a chain. Now, when we fix 1st link, then it becomes inversion 1. Okay, when this is happening, input is given to this link. This is coupler. And this will slide along this line. This is a fixed one. This is in first inversion, link one is fixed, where its application is IC engines. There we see this crank rotating, and this is nothing but an engine. We can, if you open the engine part of motorbikes, for example, we will find all this. It's a simple mechanism. And in reciprocating compressors is also another application. Now if we talk about second inversions, instead of this first link being fixed, this first link being fixed, we will fix this second link. When we do so, this will be an input, and again this will be output. This is nothing but inversion 2, and due to this certain extensions are given, and it is used as in different mechanisms. One of those mechanisms is Whitworth quick return mechanism, and another one is rotary cylinder mechanisms or rotary cylinder engine mechanisms. So here it is a double crank only, because this link which we are fixing is a shortest link only. This is an infinite length link. This 3 is greater than 2, and slider can slide along total thing. Slider, actually earlier we have discussed in previous classes, the class, that slider can be replaced by infinite length link. So anyway, that is greater than this 2 only. So all are greater than 2, so this 2 is shortest. When we fix the shortest, we adjacent to this 2 will be crank. So when we give input to 3, then this will also rotate completely. And as this rotates completely, to this link we will give some additional extensions that we will discuss in the next part. That is nothing but Whitworth quick return only. So that how it is becoming, that we will discuss next part. Just for this class, you remember that this is second inversion. If we fix the adjacent, that's the second link, and we will have two applications. Now instead of this one, we fix third link. When we fix the link, when we fix the link adjacent to the shortest one, that is link 3. This was link 2. This was link 1. This was link 3. When we fix this one, we get third inversion, where this can make complete revolution. It is a crank, and this adjustment, this slider, and this link 1. We in next classes we will be replacing, I mean making arrangement in which you will understand how it is we are utilizing these things. Application of this will be a rockery, because adjacent to shortest link is fixed. Earlier we have discussed that when adjacent to shortest link is fixed, we will get crank rocker mechanism. and application of this is crank and slotted lever mechanism. And this is a quick return mechanism, QRM. And another one is application is oscillating cylinder engine or cylindrical engine. Okay. Now the another fourth inversion will be a double rocker, where we, it means that we are fixing the biggest link. The biggest link nothing but this slider. So we can equivalently we will make it to a rotary joint, so we will replace slider joint by infinite length link. And we discussed this in earlier classes. So double rocker. So fourth inversion will be a double rocker. When we fix this fourth link, okay, we will get double rocker, because the shortest link opposite to it is link 4, 3 and 1 are adjacent, 4 is the opposite one, so coupler is being attached, I mean fixed, which gives us double rocker mechanism. When we get double rocker mechanism, and its application is in hand pumps. Most of you might have seen some extension is given to this one, this, and we will finally get hand pump. How we are getting, I will show you in the next class.